I just want to say, first of all, good evening. My name is Frank. I don't attend this church, but I do go to another church in Lancaster called Grace Gospel Church. Welcome to the Truth Troops production, and the production is called Atonement to Salvation. Tonight's play is performed in hopes to give the resurrection story, shown through real biblical accounts in history that have actually happened, in the whole of God's Word, through His holy, divinely inspired Bible. Please note that there are going to be a few scene changes, and throughout the production that will require the movement of scenery, at which point Miss Teresa will sing and play a few songs, of which the first one is called When I Lay My Isaac Down, and afterwards, after the scene of Abraham, another song will be performed by Teresa during that scene move, and it's going to be called Lamb of Glory. So at this time, we're going to open up in a word of prayer to ask the Lord to bless this service tonight, and we thank everyone here for coming on this Wednesday evening. So let's bow our heads. Gracious Father, Lord, thank you. Lord, thank you for your perfect Son in Jesus Christ, Lord. Lord, thank you. As Lord, we know that these kids worked hard, and the adults as well, Lord, just building scenery and learning lines and learning all the different directions, Lord. And Lord, it's not about the performance as much as it is the giving of the gospel, Lord. Glorifying you, Lord. We're performing to you to show you how much we love you, Lord. We thank the people here tonight, Lord, that they're here, that they wanted to come here, Lord, and see the production, Lord. But the production is meant to be an evangelistic tool, but also, Lord, just to show our love for you, Lord. Lord, we thank the churches that allowed this production to happen in their local assembly, Lord. Thank you for that, Lord. So we ask you once again, Lord, please bless this service tonight and this production, Lord. In Jesus' holy name we pray. Amen.
Noah that he would flood the earth with water and told him to make an ark so that he and his family could be saved. you imagine how precious one son would be to a man who waited so long for one? Abraham loved him so much, but God wanted something of Abraham.
Abraham. Take now thy son, thine only son Isaac, whom thou lovest, and get thee into the land of Moriah, and offer there offering a burnt offering upon one of the mountains which I will tell thee of.
And Abraham rose up. Abraham rose up early in the morning and saddled his ass. And he took two of his young men with him, and Isaac, his son. And clave wood for the burnt offering, and rose up. And they went unto a place of which God had told them. Abraham lifted up his eyes and saw the place afar off.
Abide ye here with the ass, and I and the lad will go yonder and come again to you. Here am I, my son.
Behold the fire and the wood. Where is the lamb for the burnt offering?
Well, tell me, my son, God will provide himself a lamb for the burnt offering.
So they went, both of them together. And they came to the place which God had told him of. And Abraham, he built an altar there. Abraham laid the wood in order. And Abraham bound Isaac, his son. And laid him on the altar upon the wood. And Abraham stretched forth his hand and took the knife to slay his son.
Abraham! Abraham!
Behold, here am I.
Lay not thy hand upon the lad, neither do anything unto him. For now I know that thou fearest God, seeing thou hast not withheld thy son, thine only son, from me.
And Abraham, he lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, there was a ram caught in the thicket of his horns. And Abraham went and took the ram and offered him up for a burnt offering. Instead of his son.
By myself have I sworn, saith the Lord, for because thou hast done this thing, and hast not withheld thy son, thine only son, that in blessing I will bless thee, and in multiplying I will multiply thy seed as the stars of heaven, and in the sand which is upon the seashore, and thy seed shall possess the gates of his enemies. And in the seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed, because thou hast obeyed my voice.
So Abraham returned unto his young men, and they rose up and went together to Beersheba, and Abraham dwelt. As we do a scene, Chief Teresa will sing a song.
Thank you.
someone else. Abraham loved God so much that he was willing to give up his only son. And thousands of years later, God loved us so much that he was willing to give up his only son.
You mean Jesus?
Yes. And just like Abraham believed that God could raise Isaac from the dead, God wants us to believe that he was able to raise Jesus from the dead. In the Bible, it says that we must believe that Christ died for our sins, and that he was buried, and that he rose again the third day, according to the scriptures.
I remember hearing about Jesus dying for our sins, but what does that mean? Why did he have to die?
The wages of sin is death. Whenever someone sins, the wages must be paid. God kept his promise to Abraham, and his descendants became a great nation called Israel. God gave them every advantage over other people. He blessed and protected them. He gave them his laws, and he gave them a priesthood to teach them the right way to worship God. And yet, they still sinned against God, as we all have. And this sin separated them from him. God is too holy to have fellowship with sinful people. So in his mercy, he made a way for the sins to be forgiven. But someone had to die. Blood had to be shed. Innocent blood.
For whatsoever had a blemish, that shall ye not offer. For it shall not be acceptable for you. It shall be perfect to be accepted. There shall be no blemish therein.
And every priest standeth daily, ministering and offering oftentimes the same sacrifice, which can never take away sins.
Hear the story from God's
Jesus, he said, "Behold, the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sins of the world." He called Jesus that because he was a perfect sacrifice, a lamb without blemish, the promised Messiah, sent by God to do what we could not. God humbled himself as a servant, came down as a man, and became obedient unto death.
Sleep on now. Take your rest. Behold, the hour is at hand. The Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners.
Rise. Let us be going. Behold, he is at hand that doth betray me.
Whom seek ye?
Jesus of Nazareth.
I am he. Whom seek ye?
Jesus of Nazareth.
I have told you that I am he. If therefore ye seek me, let these go their way. Put up thy sword into the sheath. The cup which my Father hath given me, shall I not drink it? Thinkest thou that I cannot now pray to my Father, and he shall presently give me more than 12 legions of angels? But how then shall the scriptures be fulfilled, that thus it must be? Be it come out as against a thief, with swords and staves. When I was daily with you in the temple, he did stretch forth no hands against me. But this is your hour, and the power of darkness.
Jesus knew they were coming to arrest him, but he let them do it. He allowed them to take him and to hang him on a tree. He chose to be beaten, spit on, cursed, rejected, and killed by the very people he came to save, because he knew that he could not save unless he died for them.
Yet he opened not his mouth. He was led as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before her shears is dumb, so he openeth not his mouth.
I am a worm and no man, a reproach of men and despised of the people. All they that see me laugh me to scorn.
He saved others, himself he cannot save. If he be the king of Israel, let him come down from the cross, and we will believe. trusted in God. Let him deliver him now if you will have him. For he said, I am the Son of God.
They gaped upon me with their mouth. They have smitten me upon the cheek reproachfully. They have gathered themselves against me.
He is despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief, and we hid, as it were, our faces from him. He is despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he hath borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God and afflicted.
They part my garments among them and cast lots upon my vesture.
But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed.
I am poured out like water, and all my bones are out of joint. My heart is like wax, is melted in the midst of my bowels.
With his own blood, he was sacrificed for us, taking away our sins.
Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. My God, why hast thou forsaken me?
Who has forsaken us not?
It is finished.
Not by the blood of bulls and calves, but by his own blood, entering once into the holy place to obtain eternal redemption for us.
Father, into thy hands I commend my spirit.
Surely this man was the Son of God. The people standing there heard Jesus pray to God, calling him Father. They heard him ask for those who murdered him to be forgiven, and they saw him commit himself to God as he died. Some people, like the centurion, realized that Jesus was truly a righteous man, the Son of God.
What did Jesus mean in Spanish?
The atonement. Jesus' work as the Lamb of God was finished. The sins of mankind had been fully paid, but by his blood, once and for all. But the story doesn't end there.
When the even was come, there came a rich man of Arimathea, named Joseph, who also himself was Jesus' disciple. He went to Pilate and begged the body of Jesus. Then Pilate commanded the body to be delivered. And when Joseph had taken the body, he wrapped it in a clean linen cloth. There came also Nicodemus, which at the first came to Jesus by night, and brought a mixture of myrrh and aloes, about 100 pound weight. And there was a Mary Magdalene and the other Mary sitting over against the sepulchre. Now the next day that followed the day of preparation. The chief priests and Pharisees came together unto Pilate, saying,
"Sir, remember that the deceiver said, while he's yet alive, 3 days I will rise again. Command the sepulcher to make sure." So the third day, lest the disciples come by night and steal him away, so the last error will be worse than the first.
You have a watch, go your way, make that sure as you can.
Many people expected Jesus to be the Messiah, and they were confused and uncertain when he died and was buried. They expected him to come as a king and save them from their enemies. They didn't realize a king came to die for them, to take away their sins, to take away our sins.
That's why Jesus had to die.
Yes, but Jesus didn't come just to die. He came to defeat death.
In the end of the Sabbath, as it began to dawn toward the first day of the week, came Mary Magdalene and the other Mary to see the sepulchre.
"Fear not, for I know you seek Jesus, which was crucified. He is not here. He is risen, as he said. Come, see the place where the Lord lay." "Go quickly and tell his disciples, he is risen from the dead. And behold, he go up before you into Galilee. There shall you see him. Lo, I have told you."
And they departed quickly from the sepulchre with fear and great joy, and did run to bring his disciples word. And as they went to tell his disciples, behold, Jesus met them.
"All hail. Be not afraid. Go, tell my brethren that they go into Galilee, and there shall they see me."
And they remembered his words, and returned from the sepulchre, and told all these things unto the 11 and to all the rest. And their words seemed to them as idle tales, and they believed them not. Then arose Peter. Peter ran unto the sepulchre, and stooping down, he beheld the linen clothes laid by themselves, and departed, wondering in himself at that which was come to pass. And behold, two of them went that same day to a village called Emmaus, which was from Jerusalem about 60 furlongs. And they talked together of all these things which had happened. And it came to pass that while they communed together and reasoned, Jesus himself drew near and went with them. But their eyes were holden that they should not know him. And he said unto them,
"What manner of communications are these that ye have one to another, as ye walk and are sad?
Art thou only a stranger in Jerusalem, and hast not known the things that come to pass in these days?"
"What things?"
"Concerning Jesus of Nazareth, which is a prophet and indeed, and word before God and all the people, and how the chief priests and elders delivered him to be condemned to death, have crucified him. For we trusted in him, it had been he which should have redeemed Israel. And beside all this, today is the third day since these things were done. Yea, and certain women also of our company made us astonished, which were earlier at the sepulchre. And when they found not his body, they came saying that they had also seen a vision of angels, which said that he was yet alive. And certain of them which were with us went to the sepulchre and found it, even so as the woman had said, but then they saw not."
"O fools, slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have spoken. Ought not Christ to have suffered these things and to enter into his glory?"
And beginning at Moses and all the prophets, he expounded unto them in all the scriptures the things concerning himself. And they drew nigh unto the village, whither they went.
Abide with us, for it's toward evening, and the day is past done.
And he went in to tarry with them. And it came to pass, as he sat at meat with them, he took bread, and blessed it, and brake, and gave to them. And their eyes were opened, and they knew him, and he vanished out of their sight.
That same night, they went to find the 11 apostles to tell them that Jesus was risen from the dead. Then Jesus appeared to them and showed the wounds in his hands. There was another time he showed himself to over 500 people at one time. Each time he taught them and helped them understand the scriptures, and he sent them out to be his witnesses to proclaim the good news of his redemption and resurrection, and to teach his commandments to all people.
Is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the world.
And when he had spoken these things, while they beheld, he, Jesus, was taken up, and a cloud received him out of their sight. And while they looked steadfastly toward heaven as he went up, behold, two men stood by them in white apparel, which also said,
Ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? This same Jesus, which was taken up from you into heaven, shall so come in like manner as you have seen him go into heaven.
For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanseth us from all sin. In whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins, according to the riches of his grace. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. He that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he hath not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. For the scripture saith, Whosoever believeth on him shall not be ashamed. And in the oldest book of the Bible, we all say, For I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. Folks, that concludes our production here. And before we close, and I want to first give a round of applause for these wonderful, wonderful actors. So let's give them a round of applause. I want to close with just some closing statements here. First, I want to thank all the players in tonight's production for putting in the time, the energy, and working hard to not only memorize lines, but build scenery, move scenery, set up scenery, learning stage directions, etc. It takes a whole bunch and hard work of everybody to do this. It truly takes many faithful people to all work together for a common goal. A special thanks to Sue, along with others, for coordinating, writing, producing portions of the play to have it come together in a final production. Everyone from the children to the adults had worked hard week in and week out since February, coming together for practices. Thank you to Faith Baptist Church and Farmersville Church for graciously hosting this production. It takes a lot by the grace of God and everyone involved to start out with a draft script and some scenery set ideas to completely executing into a final production. The goal tonight was twofold. One, to give the gospel of Jesus Christ by showing it in play form. The promise of a coming Savior to redeem mankind to save us from our sin. Through this production, showing the pictures and types of a Savior to the resurrection account. Second, it's to give all the praise and glory to the one who deserves it, the Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. We pray he was magnified tonight. I want to give a few scriptures and then we'll close in prayer. 1 Corinthians 15, verse 1 says, "Moreover, by a gentleman by the name of Paul, the apostle, writes to a church, much like this, a local assembly, but it was in Corinth. And he says this, he says, 'Brethren, I declare unto you the gospel which I preached unto you, which also ye have received, and wherein ye stand, by which also ye are saved, if ye keep in memory what I preached unto you, unless ye have believed in vain. For I delivered unto you first of all that which I also received, how that Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures.'" It's very important. "And that he was buried, and that he rose again the third day according to the Scriptures. And that he was seen of Cephas, then of the 12. After that he was seen of about 500 brethren at once, of whom the greater part remain unto this present, but some are fallen asleep. After that he was seen of James, then all of the apostles. And last of all he was seen of me also, as of one born out of due time. For I am the least of the apostles, that I am not meet to be called an apostle, because I persecuted the church of God. But by the grace of God, I am what I am. And his grace, which was bestowed upon me, was not in vain, but I labored more abundantly than they all. Yet not I, but the grace of God, which was with me. Therefore, whether we, I or they, so we preach and so ye believe." We'll close with what the gospel means. The gospel is the power of God to change lives. The word gospel means good news. It is the good news of what God has done for us through his son Jesus. And the good news of the gospel is rightly understood in light of the bad news of sin. Romans 3:23 tells us that all have sinned. Not some, but all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Romans 6:23 says the wages of sin is death. Our sin separates us from God. Nothing we can do will bridge that split between us and God. No amount of good deeds can earn our salvation. By the deeds of the law, there shall no flesh be justified in his sight. Romans 3:20. But God, and there it is, but God, commendeth his love toward us, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Romans 5:8. This is excellent news. No, this is good news. This is the gospel. Because Jesus died for our sins and was raised from the dead, we can have peace with God, Romans 5:1, and walk in newness of life. Many, we tend to forget, Romans 6:23 has a second part to that verse. It says, the wages of sin is death, but there's a but again. But the gift of God is eternal life. Amen. How? Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Jesus himself said, "I am the way." Not a way, the way. The only way. "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me." John 14:6. He is waiting for you now. We need to admit to God that we are a sinner. For those that don't know him, repent and turning away from sin and turning towards God. By faith, receive Jesus Christ as God's Son and accept Jesus' gift of forgiveness from sin. He took the penalty for our sin by dying on the cross. And we confess in Jesus Christ through faith as our Savior and Lord. Today, we can't wait on that. If for those who don't know if they're saved, then don't wait on it. It's the most important decision we'll ever make in your life. Today, if you've been saved, if you've been saved 6 months or 60 years, I encourage you to keep on serving the Lord. Keep serving him because only he is worthy. Folks, the gospel is serious. And as you've seen tonight, we've seen many pictures and types. We've seen the lamb slain, and that was Jesus Christ. John 1:28 says, "Behold, the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world." And that was Jesus Christ. So as we bow our heads today, we'll close this production and we'll pray. Heavenly Father, Lord, thank you. Thank you for dying on a... Lord, thank you, Father, for giving your Son. For your Son willingly coming down to not only... He didn't say he loved us. He showed us he loved us by going to that cross willingly. As people seen, he had to drink that cup of wrath, Lord. He was experiencing spiritual, emotional, physical turmoil, Lord, in himself, bearing the sins of the world. So we ask you, Lord, as we continue and continue on in fellowship after this production, I pray that brothers and sisters in the Lord already were blessed by this production and encouraged to just go out, grab a tract, share the good news of Jesus Christ. And Lord, those that are here tonight that don't know you, Lord, maybe they prayed a prayer, but it wasn't from their lips, or maybe they thought they did something, or they went to church and they do things, but Lord, it says, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, Lord. It's a personal, trusting relationship in the Savior, and that's in the Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, thank you. Bless the people. Bless the actors here tonight, Lord. Thank you so much for their willingness to do this production. And God's people said, amen. May be dismissed.
Okay, folks, one more thing before you go. Those of you that don't know me, I'm Pastor Kessel, Eric Kessel. I'm the pastor here at Farmersville Baptist Church. What an honor and a privilege it is to have you with us tonight. And if you would, give them one more round of applause. Phenomenal job. One thing I will say is, if you come Sunday, Paul Harvey, if you know who I'm talking about, said, we're here to, how's he put that? This is the rest of the story. Paul Harvey, and now the rest of the story. And this is not the end of the story. We still have a life here on this earth. And there's something greater coming. I hope you're looking forward to that. If you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ, you won't be able to look forward to that. But if you know Christ as your Savior, oh, what a day, glorious day, that will be. So thank you again, folks. I wish you a good night, and God bless. Thank you.
Amen.